hello my loves, welcome back to This Is What I Do. If you're new here, my name is Zanele Malandule, but you guys can call me Z or you can call me Rich Auntie. On this channel, we live, we socialize, we advise, we do DIYs, we cook, we host, we do public speaking, we do podcast, we vlog as well. If any of the above mentioned aligns with you, please do not hesitate. Click that subscribe button, like, share, and do leave your comments. So another user on Facebook wrote the following post. It reads as follows. My husband came home last week while I and the kids were in the living room watching a movie. He quickly sent them to bed. He then called me inside and kneeled to start explaining that he had impregnated a woman who is threatening to ruin our marriage unless he agrees to send her abroad. Upon calculating the cost involved, he felt we could use the money for ourselves and was therefore asking me to forgive him for cheating on me. Now my problem is I don't know how to tell my husband that that woman is just a chronic liar. I am that confident because I know my husband is medically important. However, I am scared I will lose my marriage if he gets to know that the kids at home are also not his. When I came across this post, I was like, oh my goodness, what on earth is happening? What is happening in the dating industry? I don't know how true is this post, but for some reason I want to believe that this actually does happen. It does take place. These kind of issues, they do actually exist. They do exist. So I think it might be true, it might not be true. Like, I don't know. I got it on Facebook, but oh my goodness. But looking at the overall situation about relationships these days, like, yo, we have reduced the word relationship to nothing. We have come to a point of which the word trust doesn't actually mean anything. I don't know what is actually happening. It's like something came down and cursed anything that has to do with dating. I swear to you, like, if I were a person who is still single in my 30s, like, looking at how things are happening now, how people treat relationships and marriages, and how everybody, a lot of us are so conniving, like, the conspiracy, the conspiring, like, I think I personally would come to a point where I, like, sit down and convince myself that, you know what, Zanele, you know what, like, dating, you and dating should actually just part ways right now, because, yo, but no hater, you'll be hurt, yo, you'll be hurt. Like, this situation is, like, it's not even a laughing matter, like, I kid you not, like, guys, it is so painful that these things, they actually do take place. Like, this woman is now afraid of losing the marriage, but how do you start blaming another person when you're the one who started? You know, you probably, I don't know how old the kids are. Chances are she started a long time ago before the man. So it's no use. Even if the man apologizes. Hey, Mara. I don't know. Like, what do you guys think of this situation whereby these things, they take place, you know, in our neighborhood? Relatives, they go through these things, you know, how people, like, how relationships nowadays are. I think, yeah, personally, I would just definitely convince myself that, you know what, dating and me are literally, like, over, because, yo, you know, all the pain goes straight to the heart. Pain does not go to the knee, does not go to the hand or the hair, or I don't know, like, the eye. Like, pain goes straight right here. So, like, the heart is so small. The heart is so small. Like, there's no telling, you know, what will happen to it if we don't take care of it. You know, there's no telling how long it can endure, like, that much pain, because every time there's any sort of pain, discomfort or whatever, like, it goes straight to the heart, and then the heart aches. Yo, I don't know. Anyway, before I was rudely, you know, clicked out, like, I've got this some sort of a remote right here. Oh, it's got on and off. I didn't see this, so I pressed it by mistake. That is why the video just went out like that. As I was saying, guys, like, it's all the pain, especially matters of the heart, they go straight to the heart. Like, they go straight to the heart. Like, there's no saving it, you know? Like, yo, it's so sad how we, you know, love is beautiful when it's done correctly, you know? Let me not get all personal and stuff, but love is beautiful when it's done correctly, when two people are, like, in it, you know? Like, why the multiple partners? Like, why? Like, why? You take all of this time that you have to be invested on that particular person that you're currently with right now, and then you invest it to another person, or even like multiple people. Like, how much time do you have? Like, good 12 hours that we have per day, how much time do you have to actually, like, I don't know, like, take care of like three people at the same time? It's so exhausting. Like, there's literally like no time. There's no time. The time that we are given during the day and the 12 hours at night and stuff like that, if it's used correctly, it can nurture what you have into it being this marvelous thing, this enjoyable, peaceful thing. But our time is divided. Like, like how much time do you have to nurture such, like, so many relationships at the same time? Like, one thing that I've learned for sure is that everything, whether it's done in the dark, one day it's gonna come out to light, and everything will go up in smoke. I think the word careful, there's no such thing as being too careful or being careful. Yeah, no. Things that actually just do come out in the light, you know? We get exhausted by just being with one person. Like, how much more when you are with, like, multiple people? Like, well, like, it's never gonna work. If there's too much divided attention, too many things are involved, like, there's no time for that tree to grow. There's no time to nurture it, you know? There's no time to look after it. Like, it's a done deal. Like, I personally would come to the point where I tell myself that, you know what, looking at how everything is right now in terms of dating and stuff like that, how other people are actually, like, suffering just by being in a relationship. Like, yo, like, I would, like, just sit down and take a look, and I'd be like, you know what, God, I give my life to you. Like, I can't, yo, I'm even exhausted for the relationships out there. Like, I'm exhausted. Like, you meet this person, things are not going well. You meet with this other person, things are not going well. But at the same time, it's always the same thing. People like to cheat. For some reason, it's like the devil came down and put a curse in all the relationships, you know. Even people in marriage, you know, there's, I don't know, like, they're not taking care of things, you know? Not much time is being put there and stuff like that. Like, I don't want to start preaching, but I feel like in the midst of everything, where the beauty industry is constantly redefining what beauty should be like or what beauty is, when the whole world is turning up the volume in terms of mistrust and mistreatment, you know? When the whole world is just so fascinated about playing hide and seek, and it seems to be now a norm, and it's just a normal norm, it's okay. Like, I feel like when the world is taking left instead of going right in terms of, you know, honoring the word trust, you know, and understanding what it is and what it means and what it should be, you know, between two people who chose to be together, you know, when the whole world decided to turn down the volume in terms of whether or not people are supposed to dress decently or not, when the world is starting to
introduce these things, like, I don't know, like, it's just a sign of discontentment, you know. Everybody's just not satisfied. Everybody's not satisfied, you know. You're working, you're not satisfied. You're not working, you're not satisfied. You're in a relationship, it's not satisfying. Like, you're married, you're not happy. Like, just as everything seems to not make sense, perhaps there's still that number, you know, those percentages that of people whose lives are still making sense. They are understanding that there's no saving the world. You know, I guess I cannot speak for those, you know. Those are actually like, they're actually like getting it that there's no saving the world. Like, I just want to suggest that take your life and give it to Jesus. Just take your life and give it to God. Like, part ways with a lot of things. Like, there's no saving this. Like, it's just heartache after heartache after heartache. I think I have talked a lot, but do get into the comment section. As always, I would like to know what you guys think. As much as the channel is still as small as it is, I would like to engage with you. Like, what do you think of this? There's another story that is coming. I don't know which one takes the cup between this one and this one, but you better stay tuned. Bye.